As a game developer, there are many times when I need game assets. Assets, I mean like textures, sprites, models, and so on. And I think this is something that all game programmers can relate to. They want to make a game, but they need an artist to work with to make a game together. But not anymore, because our AI has got you covered. This AI was able to generate high-quality textures for my next 3D game. And guess what? You can get those high-quality game assets all for free too. What? Yes, you heard it right. Here's how it works. Step 1. You enter a prompt. Step 2. AI generates the perfect asset you asked for. And yeah, that's it. Really. Several AI models support generating images based on another image. This option is fine if you don't know what to write in a prompt, but for the most part, I think you want to stick with the text-to-image option. This is all super cool, but how do I actually get started? You might ask. This is where things get slightly complicated. There are many different AIs that have different approaches to generating images. Out of all the options, DALL-E 2 is one of the best known AI image generators. But DALL-E 2 is paid, so if you're broke like me, if you want something free, there are popular alternatives like Midjourney and Stable Diffusion. Midjourney AI is used via its Discord bot. Semi-editor here. Turns out Midjourney is not entirely free. There is a free trial, but after generating a couple images, you have to purchase a subscription-based plan. So, as far as I know, the only viable free option is then Stable Diffusion, which is also open source. Stable Diffusion is also available for free, and you can even install it on your local machine. But let's be honest, most of us don't have super expensive, super powerful computers at home, so an ideal option is to use something called Google Colab. Go to the GitHub repository, click this link, and start clicking on run buttons from top to bottom. Once you're done, you'll get a website URL where you can use Stable Diffusion with a graphical user interface. Now to generate the assets. The AIs were able to do quite an impressive job of generating usable textures for 3D objects, especially for the environment textures. Although, you may need to manually edit your textures before you use them in your game. You see, the generated textures aren't seamless, but here's a workaround. First, you want to make your texture kind of seamless. I'm saying kind of because not only is it difficult to make the texture entirely seamless on your own, but also it won't be that noticeable when it's used with something I'm about to tell you. When you apply the texture and zoom back a bit, you'll notice how you're able to figure out there's a repetitive pattern on the surface. To fix this, use a procedural stochastic shader. This is actually a technique that's also used in my game, Project Terminal. Check out this video in the right top corner to learn more. Apart from that, you can even use a tool like Materialize to generate other maps to create better looking materials. I've had quite decent results with generating sprites, too. That is, after some minor image adjustments I've had to do. Most sprites need to be cropped, and their background needs to be manually removed. I wouldn't rely on AI to generate sprites for characters, nor tiles. Seamlessly connecting tiles together is harder with 2D sprite generations. You'll need to put a lot of effort to make the tiles seamless, and even then, they can look out of place. I would only use 2D generated assets for non-tile background assets, so things like clouds or mountains. For visual novel games, I think some scene backgrounds generated by AI can also be used. Again, you probably want to add some adjustment layers though. Spritesheets. You probably don't want to generate these. Not only do the proportions of the characters look odd, but here's a bigger problem. It's nearly impossible to get consistent characters drawn on the sprite sheet. So in the end, this is how the character sprite sheet looks like. AI image generation is definitely a cool concept. However, I highly doubt the AI image generation can completely replace the artists in the game development industries. As you've seen, the assets from AI aren't entirely perfect. For indie games with limited budgets and for small amounts of assets, sure. But at that point, I'd first look for free assets online before I use an AI to generate images. Another, probably bigger point is that a single AI-generated asset may look good on its own, but as soon as you start combining more than one AI-generated asset together, you'll notice how they don't really harmonize together. With that being said, I personally think AI image generators can be used to spark creativity. Sometimes they come up with something totally unexpected. There are also AIs that generate high-quality 3D texture models, but I'll just say that's still going to take longer until we can use them. This has been Semicoder.
Stop pushing me.
What? It wasn't me.
Well, if it wasn't you, then...
Guys.
Shh. I kind of know how to code. Yeah. You've been calling for the night out.